Just to recap, what is the analogy between three dimensions and this function f of n? It has three dimensions and it has infinite number of dimensions. The selector function here is by taking the sine of the cosine in that place. Okay, cosine is the selector function. Here the delta of n is the selector function. Similarly, what we call it as the different bases, so the dimensions x dimension, y dimension, z dimension, these are the three bases. Here the bases are equal to delta of n minus 1 and so on. Why are they bases? Because what is delta of n? It is 1 at 0 and rest everywhere. This is 1 at 1, delta of n minus 1, and similarly this x or this basis, okay, this ijk or what we tell sometimes, okay, they are nothing but 1, 0, 0, this 1 at x, 1 in pi and 1 in z, so is the same in the discrete. So we are able to understand by comparison what the discrete functions are as compared to this three dimensions. Just think of it like this, okay, by this we understand what actually this function is, and what this is very important concept, because this set of bases, this finding the set of bases is what will make us move towards the Fourier. How to find the component? What we did is that we dot product this vector v dot I. When we do v dot I, we get the component in x direction. Similarly, here we will do f of n dot delta of n minus k to get the kth component. Because, and now, how do we represent this? Like, for example, if the function is suppose incremental ramp function, okay, 1, 2, 3 dot. It can't I represent it as a vector of one row one and infinite columns? Yes, I can. So in that sense, this function, this infinite dimensional vector, when dotted with this suppose 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, then what I get, or let me say the second component, this is what we get, delta of n minus 2. When I dot product with it, I am just simply left with value 2. So this is what is the component of this big vector in this direction. Okay. So this means that if I take this delta of t minus 2 or delta of n minus 2, delta of n minus 1, delta of n, then the this component of in direction of delta of n minus 1 is scaled with 2. In some sense, this color has more weightage as compared as weightage 2, weight 2. Okay, are you getting it? This is what is the importance. So the important point which we got is that we can represent a function as a vector. Just see how I am representing it, how we are doing dot product. Similarly, what will be the dot product of f of n comma g of n? It will be nothing but just represent it as an infinite dimensional vector. Now what is it happening? It will be nothing but summation. It is this point only, okay? It will be summation f of n g of n over n. This is what will be the dot product. And that is what is the dot product. Dot product always gives a single value. So by this, we understand how to represent this function.